A very wonderful welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are going to be starting with the topic of excretion in humans by Pilani. So for us to begin with this topic, we need a basic understanding first of what is excretion, what is to excrete in the first place. So here I have tried my best to make it as simple as possible and very understandable. So what is to excrete? So I'm sure you might have heard this word maybe in grade 8 natural sciences or something like that. But then when I talk about excretion, we refer to the removal of waste from the body. So excretion generally means that we are removing or we are eliminating waste from the body. So when waste is being expelled, we say that excretion is happening. So I want you to take this definition rather. So this was just for you to understand. That's why I say it's just generally for understanding. But then I recommend that you take this definition from there. DBE textbook that says excretion is the removal or elimination of metabolic waste from an organism. So there is nothing new here besides that there is waste that is being eliminated or that is being removed from the body. But then let us understand first of all, why do we need to remove waste from the body? Because others may ask, why do you even go to the toilet? Why do you even urinate and whatnot? So the reason here is that when waste accumulates, it becomes dangerous to the cells, tissues, organs, and the systems of the body. So if you do not go to the toilet to excrete the waste, the feces particularly, or to go urinate or something like that, that waste will accumulate and it ends up being dangerous to your cells. The cells of your body and the tissues of your body, as well as other organs of your body, they want the waste to move out of the body so that they can function efficiently or function properly. So if the waste is accumulating and you are not going to the toilet to expel it, then it will be very dangerous. It can be even fatal. So now, let us look at the excretory organs that we have. So in our saying we're talking about excretory organs, what are we referring to? We are referring to the organs in the body or the parts of the body that actually are responsible for removing the waste. So the waste is not only going to urinate and going to, you know, like feces and whatnot, but there are other types of waste that you'll be introduced to in this. So the first organ, the first excretory organ that we have are the lungs. So the lungs, as you know them, I'm sure you know them from gaseous exchange. Lungs excrete carbon dioxide as well as water vapor. So these are the products or the excretory products. So if whenever they ask you of excretory, let me just write it down, excretory products, they want to know what actually comes out of your body, because that is what you're excreting, that is what the body is expelling. Yes, so here when we're talking about these excretory products, we are just trying to answer the question that what actually comes with the waste that actually comes off your body, what is it? Okay, so in the case of lungs, the waste that will come out of the body is carbon dioxide as well as water vapor. So you might wonder how the carbon dioxide leaves the body and the water vapor, but it actually leaves whenever you exhale or when you breathe out. So whenever you are breathing out, like the water vapor and the carbon dioxide will be leaving the body. But then they're actually coming from the lungs. So the lung is the excretory organ. And then the skin is another excretory organ. So the skin excretes mineral salts, traces of urea. So mineral salts are actually nutrients, salts, just like any salts in your body. So those salts actually move through the skin. So when they move through the skin, what is the product? What is the excretory product? Or what is it that actually comes out of your skin? It is the sweat. So sweat is the excretory product. Let me actually use another color. So sweat is the excretory product. In this case, water vapor and carbon dioxide are the excretory products. So if you are going to say that the excretory products here for the skin is mineral salts, it will be wrong. It will be wrong because what is actually being excreted is sweat. So the mineral salts are inside the sweat. So you might wonder when do you need to use the mineral salts? But then we can just say the mineral salts are actually the waste products, whereas the products that is actually excreted, it is the sweat. It contains the mineral salts. And the other excretory organ which we have is the liver. So the liver, as you know it, maybe you know it in homeostasis or something like that. So the liver excretes urea and bile pigments through feces. Okay, so when you are talking about urea, it is just some, you know, can say some compound or some chemical that is secreted in your body or that is produced by your body, right? So the liver excretes that urea because if it continues being inside your body, it can end up harming your cells and whatnot. So now the liver excretes urea and bile pigments. So these are the waste products. These are the waste products that are excreted by the liver. Waste products. And then what is the excretory product, or what is the actual thing that comes out of your body? Because you can never see urea and bile pigments. Okay, so what is it actually that is excreted out of your body? It is your feces. Remember, it is the feces that come from the anus. So those feces contain urea and bile pigments. So this is the excretory product as well. And then now the colon is another one. Remember, the colon is another name for the large intestine. Yes, the large intestine is otherwise known as the colon. So now the colon also excretes bile pigments, just like the liver, bile pigments as well as excess mineral salts. So remember that the absorption of mineral salts according to digestion, it actually happens at the large intestines, right? Yes. So if there are extra mineral salts after they are absorbed, the excess ones, when you say excess, we're talking about the more than enough. So in this case, if there are more than enough mineral salts after they are absorbed in the colon, then they will be excreted through what? Through feces. So the waste product is the bile pigments and the excess mineral salts, and the excretory product is the feces. Yes. And then now the kidney is the last excretory organ that we're gonna be talking about. The kidney excretes urea as well, just like the liver. So it excretes urea, mineral salts, and water. So these three are actually our waste products, or these are the waste products that are excreted by the kidney. But how are they excreted? They are excreted through urine. So urine is our excretory product, whereas the waste product is urea, mineral salts, and water. I hope this gives you insight on starting this topic of excretion in human beings, because in the next video we will be starting with the urinary system, which involves how is urine created, how is urine produced, and how are these urea, mineral salts, and water excreted through urine. That's what you're going to be looking at. Thank you for watching. If this video helped you, don't forget to hit subscribe. Tell your friends to stay tuned.